Hi and welcome to my channel. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to create a CSS text animation with variable fonts like you can see on my screen. To begin, I'll quickly outline what variable fonts are and what benefits they have. So with regular fonts, you generally have to import various font faces if you want different weights and styles, such as italic. This means the browser needs to make several HTTP requests to obtain these files. Additionally, the more fonts you add, the bigger their combined size gets. With variable fonts, however, you don't have this issue. You only need to make one HTTP request for a single file that contains all the styles and weights. This variable font file is generally as large as four regular font files combined, according to the Mozilla documentation, and you get way more options than you would with regular fonts. For example, you can vary the font weight significantly and even use weights that regular fonts don't offer. As you can see on my screen, one of the paragraphs has a weight of 399, while the other has 750. It is not only the weight of the text that you can vary though. Depending on the font, you can also change other attributes as this page illustrates. Now let's create the CSS animation. I have a basic HTML file which has the style sheet linked. The CSS file itself is empty. Additionally, I also have a folder with fonts. The font I am using for this tutorial is called Movement, and you can download it from nmtype.com/movement. Simply scroll to the bottom of the page and click the variable font option. I have also linked this site and some other pages offering variable fonts for free use below for you. So to begin, I will add an H1 with some text to the body, which is the only markup we need. Next, in the CSS file, I am going to paste in some root variables, which includes three colors and two text shadows. These shadows I am going to use to achieve the neon glow effect we have seen at the beginning. With this out of the way, let's import the file font that we have in the fonts folder. To do this, we need to type @font-face and then curly brackets. Within the curly brackets, the first property we need is the font family. Here you can name the font, which I am naming Movement. The next property is src, and you need to add URL with the file path to the font file here. Then in the body, I am specifying that the page should use this font with font family Movement. I have live reload enabled, so when I save the changes, you can see that the text is now displayed with this Movement font. I want to position the heading in the center of the site, so I am quickly going to add some basic styles. Height 100VH to make the body as tall as the visible height of the browser window. And I am also using Flex with Justify Content and Align Item Center to position the text right in the middle. The overflow I am specifying as hidden, so there is no scroll, and the background color I am changing to dark gray. The text is now not really visible, but we'll take care of that next. The color of the H1 should be white. I am making the text size responsive with the calc function. It basically will always add up 1.5 frames with 5VW. As the VW depends on the width of the browser, the wider the window, the bigger the font gets. Next, I want to add a 5-pixel spacing between the letters with the letter spacing property. Now it's time to define the CSS animation. To declare the animation, I am using the keyword @keyframes and I am assigning it the name change. At the beginning, so at 0%, I am declaring the property font variation settings, which allows us to alter the style of the variable font. I want to set the weight, which I can do with the string WGHT and writing 100 right next to it. Note you don't need to separate them with any symbols such as colons. The weight property is not the only thing I want to alter. This font has another one which is called SBAC and relates to the style of the corners of the text. If I add 100 here, they will be sharp. To add several properties, you just need to separate them with a comma. At 100%, I want to increase the font weight and I want to make the corners rounded. To achieve this, I can use font variation settings again and define weight as 200 and SBAC as 120. That's all we need. We can now assign it to the H1 with animation name change, animation duration 5 seconds, animation direction alternate so the animation runs back and forth, and animation iteration count infinite so it continues playing. If I save this, you can see that the text starts changing. It is a bit slow, so I am decreasing the duration to 2 seconds. I am also quickly adding the text shadow to the animation so that the glow is visible and changes too. At the start, it should be a bluish color, and at the end, a pink one. And this is the final result. As there are many variable fonts out there with various properties, you can create different animations and come up with different designs. I, for example, have created another one like this, for which I will link the source code below as well. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please subscribe. I put out front-end development videos regularly. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and I'll try to answer. Thanks for watching and see you next time!